Good morning, and welcome back to the Ram Report Morning Show. I'm your host, Lara Pavlovic, as always, bringing you the Hightstown Scoop. As we enter the month of March, we here at the Ram Report recognize the rich history of women, not only here in the U.S., but around the world. If you're interested in learning more about women's history, the Hightstown High School Library has an excellent selection of books and other resources that you can find on the East Windsor Regional School District website. Due to Corona, our students have had trouble keeping up with the Hightstown sports teams, and that's why we're here to help. Here's Matthew Salter with our sports recap.
The Hightstown boys basketball's strange COVID season has quickly approached the end. Last Thursday, the boys were playing to stay alive for a chance in this year's Mercer County tournament. Unfortunately, the boys took a devastating 83-63 loss to Nottingham. It was a tight game throughout as the Rams were up 3 going into the fourth quarter, but Nottingham railed with a 36 points and the Rams only answered with 13. In the loss, Spencer Kenny had a season-high 22 points. The Rams wrapped up the regular season with a record of 6-6, but disappointingly are likely to be left out of this year's MCTs. They still will have a chance to play for the CBC title in their pod, though. We'll be rooting our boys on here at the Ram Report. I'm Matthew Salter with the Ram Report. Back to you.
Thanks, Matt, and good luck to our sports teams as they try to compete for a 2021 division title. Once again, the Ram Report is continuing its weekly COVID update, this time with a new and improved vaccine. Here's Alejandro with more information.
Thank you, Laura. The Johnson & Johnson COVID-19 vaccine has finally been authorized for the FDA for emergency use. Unlike the other vaccine currently unavailable, the Johnson & Johnson vaccine only requires one shot in comparison to the usual two that must be taken over a two-month period. The Johnson & Johnson vaccine is 72% effective at preventing severe or critical forms of COVID-19 28 days after vaccination. According to the results from Phase 3 clinical trial, it will be a critical tool in creating herd immunity. It's much faster to vaccinate a greater portion of the population with one dose vaccine. 300 million doses of vaccine have already been distributed to various vaccination centers across the country. New Jersey Governor Phil Murphy has announced that the teachers are being added to the vaccine priority, beginning on March 15th. President Joe Biden urged states to get teachers on the list for one dose vaccine by the end of the month. Other groups are being added to this list to include transportation workers, public safety workers, and migrant farm workers, and the homeless. Thank you.
Thank you, Alejandro. With teachers soon to be vaccinated, hopefully we can get back to a normal school schedule. Ninth graders, now you don't have to worry about Zoom meetings and Chromebooks not working properly. Here's Tilak Patel with more information.
As we all know that Chromebooks we have are not very great for Zoom and virtual meetings. Because these Chromebooks have some problems like microphone not working, video not working, voice cutting out, or not being able to connect to Zoom. In this all Zoom issues and Zoom meeting not working properly, 9th graders got a chance to exchange their Chromebooks this week. We asked some 9th graders to review their new Chromebooks.
So what do you think the benefit is going to be? Is the mic going to work and the camera going to work?
I think it's going to work better. The Chromebook looks better.
I'm Tilak Patel for Ram Report. Back to you in the studio.
Thanks, Tilak. Let's hope these new Chromebooks are better than the old ones. Calm yourself down with a new segment called the Ram Report Moment of Zen. We have Josh Carmona here to talk about a new club that helps Rams achieve inner peace.
Namaste, Rams. Are you feeling stressed throughout the school day? Well, there's no need to fret. Miss Adams is launching a new program where every Wednesday starting on March 17th from 12:15 to 12:45, they'll be hosting wellness meetings on Zoom. These meetings will go for about 6 to 8 weeks and there's no commitment, so you don't have to go to every single meeting.
Hi everyone, my name is Tara Adams and I'm the Rutgers School-Based Counselor here at Hightstown. The group will offer you a break in between your busy days and schedules to learn and practice mindfulness techniques such as basic breathing, simple yoga poses, meditations, and other ways to relieve stress. So if you're in need of a little Zen in your life, I hope to provide you with a place to pause and reset.
We've been in this pandemic for around a year, so we should be glad to have opportunities like this. I'm Josh Cremona with the RAM Report. Back to you. Namaste.
Thank you, Josh, and namaste. Have you heard? The Shamrock Shakes are back at McDonald's, but this year, they're facing some fierce competition. Continuing the RAM Report food review saga, here's Barker Bennick.
Top of the morning, Rams. It's March, and you know what that means. March Madness, the beginning of spring, St. Patrick's Day, and with it, of course, the return of the Shamrock Shake at McDonald's. Only showing up for a limited time each year, it's the perfect accompaniment to a traditional Irish meal. This green drink is truly beloved and also truly elusive, just like the pot of gold. However, continuing with last week's theme of competition, there's a challenger on the horizon looking to take Ronald McDonald's spot at the top of the rainbow. This time around, we have Dairy Queen with their very creatively named Mint Shake, seemingly designed to tussle with McDonald's classic Shamrock Shake. Will it stack up? Let's find out. All right, I'm just about ready to hop in the car and go to Dairy Queen to grab my Mint Shake. But before I do that, we gotta go over the three categories that we're reviewing the shake on. Just like last week, if the Dairy Queen Mint Shake scores a perfect 3 out of 3, that means it'll be just as good as the McDonald's Shamrock Shake. Similar to how we rated the McDonald's chicken sandwich versus the Popeye's chicken sandwich last week. It's certainly gonna be a tough feat for the Dairy Queen Mint Shake, but first, let's introduce our categories. First, we have our mintiness. Is the minty flavor overpowering, or is it barely present at all? Next, we have our consistency. How does it feel in the mouth? Viscosity for our chemistry buffs out there. Is it too watery, or is it too thick like ice cream? Does it scratch the itch that a shake should, right in the middle of the two? And our last category, of course, we have whipped cream, an essential topping of a shake. But will Dairy Queen's be any quality compared to McDonald's? Just about ready to hop in the car, so let's go find out for ourselves. Here we go, in all its glory. Let's take it home. All right, so we're back home. Here's a shake. Didn't actually know that there was chocolate in it, so I'll take that into consideration. Also, there's no whipped cream, which is something that McDonald's does have. But, yeah, maybe the chocolate will be able to make up for the lack of whipped cream. Let's get inside and review this. Alright, so I got my shake right here, ready to give it a review. Wish I got some more shots of the roadways, some road signs to make the journey a little bit more interesting, but I was behind the wheel, so keep that in mind. Drive safe. Don't use your phone while you're driving. Now that I've got that little PSA out of the way, let's get into the shake. So right away, one thing I do notice is that the chocolate is very prevalent. Lot of little pieces of chocolate in there. It's actually called a mint chip shake. Which would be a more adequate name than just Mint Shake now after seeing it. But, yeah, it's good. I'll go in for another sip right here. It's actually quite good. It's taken me by surprise. I thought it would be very difficult for any shake to match the mintiness of McDonald's. But, yeah, I definitely think that this is, in terms of mintiness at least, definitely up there with McDonald's. Definitely a contender with the Shamrock Shake in terms of the actual mint flavor. Unfortunately though, in my opinion, the chocolate is not able to make up for a lack of whipped cream, which is a leg that McDonald's does have above the Dairy Queen Mint Chip Shake. But overall, the mint flavor is still very good. Very similar to a Shamrock Shake in my opinion. Other than the chocolate, of course. Take another sip and then we'll get into the consistency of the shake. Yeah, once again, that mint flavor is actually really good, but consistency, it is a little soft, especially when compared to the McDonald's Shamrock Shake. But in all honesty, that's kind of up to preference, and it's nothing that you couldn't just solve by, if you like your shakes a little bit softer, you just let them sit. If you like your shakes a little bit thicker, you put them in the freezer, put them in the fridge. So there's really no issues with the shake that you couldn't solve on your own. I can confidently give the shake a 2 out of 3 Rams. One of the categories that it definitely lives up to McDonald's against is the mint flavor. It's actually very good. And in terms of consistency, I don't think there's anything quite wrong with it for a shake. It feels quite good in the mouth. It's not very thin. Not too thin, but also, you know. Yeah, it fits right in the middle right there. The only one that I would knock against it is the lack of whipped cream, and I don't think that the chocolate's enough to make up for it. But it's still definitely a very good shake. Highly recommend going out there and getting your own mint shake, trying it for yourself, so you can form your own opinion. So I'm going to drink the rest of the shake because this is really good. But 2 out of 3 Rams from the Ram Report, so not quite enough to live up to the Shamrock Shake, but still a valuable contender. Go out and get your own. I'm Parker Bennick with the Ram Report. Back to you in the studio.
Thank you, Parker. But don't take his word for it. You can always go out and try both of these shakes for yourself. And with that, another episode of the Ram Report comes to a close. Be sure to come back next week for another helping of the Heightstown Scoop. Stay safe, have a good weekend, and as always, have a Ramtastic day.